This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way. Life seems to grab hold wherever it can. Deep sea vents, rocky cliffs, the underside of my windowsill. Everywhere except the tippy tops of mountains. But why does nothing grow up there? Hey everyone, Julia here for DNews. The tree line is the elevation above which trees can't grow. From a distance, the line can seem so extreme, but up close it's a little fuzzier. It's more of a squiggly patch where flora grows thinner and thinner until no trees grow in a place called the alpine zone. So some scientists use the definition, the elevation where tree density declines or drops to zero. But that elevation is different in lots of different places. You might not be surprised to learn there's a relationship between treeline and latitude. Tree lines are pretty consistent between 30 degrees north and 20 degrees south, but the further you move from that, the lower the tree line is. And within latitudes, it can differ a surprising amount. Like for example, the tree line in the eastern United States is lower than out west. The Tetons in Wyoming are at 43 degrees latitude, and the White Mountains in New Hampshire are at 44 degrees, so pretty close. But in the Tetons, the tree line sits at a chilly 10,000 feet, while the White Mountains, it sits at a cozy 4,500 feet. What's going on? Researchers have found that tree lines seem to follow the permanent snow line of mountains, which might mean temperature is the major factor. And temperature really screws up two main things for trees. It limits how seeds sprout and limits how the tree can grow. If the elevation is too high, it's too cold, or snow might last too long into the summer and trees have a hard time growing. It seems trees have a hard time building cells if the temperatures dip below 44 degrees Fahrenheit. But summer temperatures matter a lot too. If the snow lasts too long, it might cut the growing season short, leaving trees struggling. Even on the same mountain, it can vary. Some rock faces get more sun, some get more rain, some more wind. Ever been on a mountain and noticed how a slope on one side seems to have more trees? Well, shadows sometimes stunt tree growth. In the northern hemisphere, north-facing slopes have a lower tree line because the shade makes that side colder than the other. It's the opposite for the southern hemisphere. Other factors matter too. If the tree line is caused by wind, it might make the trees tiny, almost more like bushes. The trees are called the Krumholz formation, from the German word for twisted wood. Since temperature and tree line are linked, it's no surprise that climate change has an effect. So scientists are starting to keep an eye out on tree lines. Just like stunning images of retreating glaciers, moving tree lines might be a striking visual for the way our world is transforming. All right, guys, got any questions about how our weird world works? Let us know in the comments down below. While you're at it, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week. This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.